Oh, I've been expecting you. It's been a bit longer than the last time, but I knew that you'd be back like before, ready to talk about more tales from my collection. And with that being said, I'm happy to discuss any and all books and tales from the pages. So, with that being said, let me be your guide into the world between where fantasy and reality meet and meld together. You'll be perfectly fine as long as you remember one thing. It's only a story. Tonight I'd like to talk to you about a book, a story. That's another one of my favorites, a book by Mr. Clive Barker. The book entitled
The Hellbound
And it's another book that has a movie adaptation to it. The movie adaptation is entitled Hellraiser. There is a few differences, and I will try to hold back as much as I can, but there will be spoilers in here if you have not seen the book, or if you have not read the book or seen the movie. This is your final warning to leave the sacks now. So without further ado, The Hellbound Heart is a horror story by Clive Barker and is a movie adaptation with some differences. In the book, Rory Cotton moves in to his to an older family home with his new wife, Julia. One thing I want to point out is that Rory Cotton's name in the movie was changed to Larry Cotton. And Rory is unaware that his brother Frank was squatting in the house before him and got into some pretty dark things, namely the Cenobites, interdimensional beings from hell that take pleasure in sadomasochism. After Frank released the Cenobites from the Lamont configuration, he released them with the intent of experiencing their pleasures, not realizing that to them, pain was pleasure. Larry, I'm sorry, Rory's, high school girlfriend Kirstie comes to visit him as he's getting settled in, and that is another difference. In the movie, Kirstie is represented as Kirstie Cotton, his daughter by another marriage, not his current wife, but another marriage. But in the book, she is not his daughter. She is an old high school fling. I'm unsure if it ever says what her last name is. I don't think it mentions it in the book. But if I am mistaken, please feel free to correct me. And Larry cuts himself while moving into the house. Frank finds a way to slip away from the Cenobites and come back into the human world by taking the flesh and blood of others, and convinces Julia to help him murder people. Kirstie never liked Julia and still has feelings for Rory. Frank had always been kind of like a problem child in Rory's life, in the way that he had no respect for anybody and even had a love affair with his second wife before and after they had gotten married. And Kirsty tried to watch Rory's new wife, Julia, as she suspected Julia was messing around with other men, which not even she could have fathomed the horrible truth. Julia was bringing men home for Frank, so Frank could take their flesh and their blood to make himself whole. One day, Julia brings home a gentleman who breaks down in a rage at her infidelities and attacks her, but is saved when Frank pulls him off of her and drags him into the attic. This is when Kirsty tries to confront Julia and learns the horrible truth when Frank tries to attack her and tries to sexually assault her. During the attack, one difference from the movie, in the movie, Kirsty gets away relatively easy by grabbing the Lamont configuration and tossing it out the window. In the book, it is a different story as Frank forces her to the floor and violently beats her almost unconscious before Kirsty goes unconscious and before Frank can have his way with her. She, like in the movie, grabs the Lamont configuration and uses it to get Frank off of her by knocking him in the side of the head with it and then tossing it out the window and running out as this, like, distracts him long enough. When she runs outside, she grabs the Lamont configuration and takes off, but soon collapses, as she did in the movie, and ends up in the hospital. Kirsty is unaware of what the Lamont configuration actually is, and ends up summoning the Cenobites, much like in the movie, when she starts playing around with the small gold puzzle box. And much like in the movie, she tries to make a deal with the Cenobites, claiming that Frank escaped them and that she could help them lure him out. And they agree to let her try to prove what she says is the truth. After that, they let her go, and she goes back to Rory's house, unaware that Rory is already dead, and Frank is wearing his skin. As Kirsty's theft of the puzzle box left him worried about the Cenobites coming after him, so needing flesh, he took his own brothers and intended to leave, but after he dealt with Kirsty being a sicko, he waited for Kirsty at Rory's house. When Kirsty showed up, she was unaware, with the Cenobites still close behind her. She tried to tell Rory that his brother Frank was still alive and that he was in the house. But it didn't look like they were going to believe her until she realized, like much out of the movie, that Frank had taken Rory's skin and had assumed his life. Much like in the movie, Frank kills Julia as he has no more use for her. But the Cenobites appear again. This book is very, very close to the movie. It has some differences, like Pinhead being a woman in here instead of a man. And unlike out of the movie, the Cenobites actually keep their word and let Kirsty go after they drag Frank back to hell. Kirsty is on the book ends with Kirsty being on the side of the sidewalk and somebody bumping into her jogging along, but the person who bumped into her was wearing a hoodie and sweats. She didn't get a look at their face, but she felt them shove something into her pocket. When she pulled it out, she pulled out a small gold puzzle box called the Lamont configuration. And this implies that her fate will be interconnected to it from here on out, as she also, in a manner of speaking, escaped the Cenobites. This book is very good and very fleshed out despite its short runtime, but because it is a short story and not longer, I give this book 3.5 bookmarks out of 5. Still a very good read, but really too short to get into it long term. Well, I think that's all the time we have now. I know this wasn't as long as some other episodes, but maybe we'll have more time next time. Until then, be careful staring into the dark, because you never know what's staring right back at you.